So, you want to learn how to fold men's underwear? Well, you have come to the right place. Last year we made a video about this and it was a huge success, so I want to update it for this year. I got a lot of cool stuff that I want to share with you. I want to show you a quick and simple way that you can use. I want to show you one that's really nice for organizing your stuff. And I also want to show you my personal favorite, which is really nice and space saving. So we're gonna have a look at all types of underwear. I have boxers here, I have briefs, I have boxer briefs. What more could you ask for? So let's start out with the simplest way, which will be the flat fold. And let's start with the boxer brief. So I may use the boxer and boxer brief interchangeably as the fold is exactly the same on both of them. So the first thing that you want to do is start with your underwear facing up like this. And then from here, we're gonna split the underwear into three parts. Now this first part where we split it into three here will kind of be repeated throughout most of the folds that we do. So we're going to split it into three and we're going to fold it over like this, one third of the way. And then we're going to take the other side here and we're going to fold it over the first fold like this. So now it's one third of the size here and yeah, this is a good place to start. Make sure it's kind of even. If you use regular boxers to do this and it kind of flares out, just stuff them a little bit underneath so that it's nice and straight. So from here, we're going to split it in the middle here, the other direction, and we're going to fold it over like this. Now this is a really quick and simple way to fold underwear. So the same method can be used for your tidy whities here. So let's do it on one of these as well. All right, so I'm going to start off again with the briefs laying flat down facing up like this. At this point I'm going to split it into three parts again, so folding the first side over like this and then the other side again, and at this point you can fold it in half. That's the simplest way to do it. Now personally I don't really like to use this method. The reason is because when you stack them on top of each other like this, it can be very difficult to see what underwear you have. An alternative is to kind of stagger them in your drawer, so you would have them like this so that you can see what you have. But again, it's going to be difficult to pick them out, and also it isn't really space efficient. So I want to show you a different take on this fold that will allow you to file fold them so that you can stack them standing up. This is a really cool method that's been popularized by a woman named Marie Kondo. By the way, if you're wondering why I have so much tidy whities, no, I don't really use them, but I've been working on this dresser organizing course. That's gonna be really awesome, but it's not ready yet. I'll give you an update once it is though. So let's get started here. I wanna use the boxers here for once, since we didn't use that in the last method. So I'm just gonna move some of this other stuff away here. So for the boxers here, they are a lot bigger, but this will also work just the same way for your boxer briefs. So the first thing you want to do is again split it in three like this, and then fold one third of the way in on one side, and you guessed it, one third of the way in on the other side as well. So as you can see here, this is a boxer's problem. You can't get this flaring effect here, so you kind of need to fold it underneath a little bit like this, straighten it out. Just you don't need to take long on this, just spend an extra second or two. And I think your underwear drawer will look so much nicer and more organized. So at this point, we're back where we usually are. Now, instead of splitting it down the middle here, I'm gonna split it into three parts actually. So it's probably easiest if you fold from the bottom up here. So you take your first third and you fold it up once, and then you take that and you flip it over one more time like this. So you can see it's a lot smaller now, but slightly thicker. Now this is really nice because now you can lift it up like this and it will stand on its own. Now if it doesn't stand on its own at first, just kind of massage it and give it a little bit of a squeeze here and it will nicely stand on its own. So this is going to work really nicely for your briefs as well. So let me show you how to do it on those two. So splitting it into three parts, fold one side in. You're getting familiar with this now, so I'm going to do it a little bit quicker. So again, splitting it into three parts. I like to start from the bottom, especially on briefs, since they're way less stable at the bottom. And then fold it over one more time, like this. And you should be able to put them up like this. And again, if they look kind of wonky, just massage them a little bit, show them a little love. And yeah, these are really nice because you can stack them next to each other in your drawer. Now, as you can see, this method was really quick, right? And they do save some space. They're really nice and organized, but they can be a little bit flimsy, I think, especially if you don't have an organizing system in place. Now, I haven't yet, but I think next week I will make a video for you where I basically make a cooked down version of my course that you can have and check out. There we'll be putting in an organizing system and I'll show you how to organize your drawer. Yeah, so next week. If you're watching this a week after I publish this video, I'm gonna link it at the end of the video so you can click that next. So the biggest drawback of the KonMari method as our file folding system is that it's flimsy, right? So this can happen if you're outside in the wind or something like that. All right, so let me show you kind of a modified version of this that you can use on your underwear to make it more secure. So again, we're just gonna fold it in 1/3 on this side, 1/3 on the other side, make sure that everything is nice and straight. And then from this point, we're gonna split it into 3 parts. I'm gonna flip over the first, like this. And then at this point, I'm gonna lift up the top band here and I'm gonna take this little floppy part. Now, if you're using briefs or boxer briefs, you kind of need to fold them in a little bit so that you create kind of this shape. And then you just stuff this in underneath the top band like this. Now to make it nice and even, I found a trick where you take your thumbs and you put them on the back side, both hands, while you take your index fingers and you stuff them underneath the band. Just kind of straighten it out, make it look nice, like this. Here you have a nice and modified version of the KonMari fold. So are you ready to learn the best way to fold men's underwear? I got it right here in my hand. Now, I call this the block rolling method. Some call it military fold. I've heard burrito roll. We have a saying in Norway that a loved child has many nicknames. So yeah, let me show you how to do this properly. So I want to show you just a basic way to do it first, and then I'm going to show you a proper, really cool way to do it after. So again, starting with the boxers here facing up, and I'm splitting it into 3 parts. Bam, bam, turn around so that you have the bottom facing you, and start rolling it up. Now you want to take kind of your, make a little crabby grip here, and start rolling, just kind of flatten it out as you move your way up, fold. Once you reach the top, you have a nice little roll. As you can see, it takes very little space. If you stack it vertically like this, it's gonna be really nice and organized. Now there is a problem with this roll. As you probably can see, it doesn't hold very well together. So what do we do about this, you may ask? Well, I have the answer to that as well. So before we start rolling, you're gonna take your underwear here, and you're gonna flip the band over so that it's the wrong way, and it kind of covers the rest of the boxers, boxer briefs. This works for any type of underwear. So probably you want to fold it out maybe 2 inches, about 5 centimeters should be good for a large boxer briefs. If you have boxers, you may need to do 3 inches. And for your briefs, I will show you afterwards. I got a better way to fold briefs. So again, we're starting here with the boxers facing up like this, and we're just splitting it into 3 parts. Bam, bam, like this. Turn it around so that it's the bottom is facing you. And it's the same procedure as the last time in that we're just gonna roll it up like this. However, this time, when you reach the top, take your one hand and grab hold of the entire roll. Lift it up like this and hold on to the bottom with your one hand. With your other hand, you want to take this band here and you're going to flip it over the rest of the roll, like so. I like to do one of the sides at a time so that you hold on to the bottom with one hand. Once you've done that, you can take your free hand, grab hold of this top side, turn it around like this, and then you have your other newfound free hand to flip the other side over as well. So at this point, you can kind of see it looks kind of wonky here. So you can kind of massage it if you want. However, I like to do like I showed you before, just stick either my index fingers or my thumbs inside, just kind of stretch it out, make it look nice and even. And here you have the secret to folding men's underwear, the perfect fold. I'm going to show you more on this next week, where I show you how to organize the dresser and folds all your clothes to save the maximum amount of space. But I have this block crawling system that I call it, that I like to stack these vertically, and you can see it's really nice and easy to see in here. So let me show you one more time on the briefs. Yeah, okay, so it's the same on the boxers, so I don't want to show you those. But for the briefs, I have a better way to do this. So of course you can do it with the briefs as well, like this, bam, bam, bam. And then you roll up to the top, flip it over. However, there is a better way to do it for the briefs, I think. So instead you want to start with your briefs facing up like this, and then you're going to take this band here from the top and you're going to roll it over once, twice, and one more time halfway up so that it stands up like this. At this point you're going to split it into three again, and you're going to take both sides and you're going to fold it backwards like this, back to the back. And you're going to do the same thing on the other side so that the other side here goes over this side. So again, from this perspective, you're going to lift it up and you can see this part is going to fall down. Now you want to flip it back over and open up this fold here that we have created. So you just stuff this part inside here like this. Make sure that everything goes in there. And then this band can be flipped over the rest once and twice. Again, you can kind of stick your index fingers in there and just kind of straighten it out to make it look nice. This also goes really nice in my folding system in the dresser. I'm going to link it here now if you're watching this a week after I've made a video. Definitely check it out. It's going to be my entire course kind of condensed down to a short video. And if it's not out, I have a bunch of other videos that you can check out if you want to learn how to fold clothes. Kind of been obsessing about it lately, so yeah.